psychology, if you will. It's the psychology behind the colors of the chords. And what's the difference between interpretation that you will give to us? Nobody. Of course, there's only one chord. If chord hears this chord is more mellow or more CV or more time, well, so does your rhythm. So make sure that first there is you and your feelings. Then there is, it has to affect the tempo, the moods, the color, and go at it in the Horowitzian way. I don't know, just want to end with this. There was a book of great teachers, and believe me, there was Leon Fleischer, name it, the, you know, those great minds of the piano world. And there was Horowitz in there. Is that a teacher? There were three words. Exaggerate, exaggerate, exaggerate. And I must tell you that when you play with orchestra, when you are on stage and sweating, something happens to us that we shrink a little bit. And so when you have exaggerated, and you say, I think that, and I'm thinking, it remains, it's something left. Otherwise, if I play very beautifully and simply here, but then I go in tempo with orchestra, it's mechanical. I'm not a mechanical person, but that will be deep. So make sure when you record yourself, pass yourself between your inner image, and it's not easy when you're in school. We have teachers and they tell us things and we love them and we respect them. But I think that there should be suggestions. Mr. So-and-so suggests. Mr. So-and-so also said, for you to take into account that in the end, you have to drink them. You have to assimilate them to the degree where you think, sorry, I can't do that. Or if I reveal something that sounds right, you'll always have someone telling you, this was too rubato, this was too strict. In the end, you're pleasing yourself. It has to be as you play. You think, I never heard it so beautiful. Then you're in good shape. At least one person liked it. But if I'm going to play a silly accent because it's triple sforzandissimo, you say, that was a little weird. What do you think? Well, it's written. You think, Frank is not very developed. You know, he follows everything like a little soldier. And we are artists, you're much more than a reproducing machine. You're a man, and with all your feelings. So pass all of this by you, because I feel that what you did with more freedom is like, wow, what colors. So they are in you, it's nothing new.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
It's also an opportunity. You know, it's so rare that we get a chance to actually play pieces. If you ask me, do you want 20 lessons or 20 concerts where you play the whole thing? Take 20 concerts any day. Because it will tell you something about you and the whole that no lesson can tell you.
texture, and it's all about the color and this one little detail. And when you are lucky to work with great artists, you are looking at very large structures. And then you see that the dynamics, interestingly, instead of being a proof of expression, you know, a sensitive after all, or you're so emotional, some nonsense like that, become a realization of what the music actually is. And so very often in terms of bar lines, how far it extends, and therefore the crescendos, and then if you had a very, very large graph, as large as this room, and you could go from the beginning of your sonata, not turning pages, on a one line, you would say, this is a kind of climax. You know who worked like that? It was actually Balanchine. He worked in reverse. When they asked Nureyev what was so great about it, he said, well, he looked at the last climax of the Sleeping Beauty, and he said this was lyrical, and the one before was angry and explosive, and you were left with a chain. Same in within piano, because on the score, piano is piano for this forte, and that was remarkably well done. Tell us a little bit where you are at with the piece, and you're obviously very advanced with it, but what are you struggling or searching and looking for yourself?
I'm still, the third movement is the part that gives me the most trouble. There's something about it that I can't seem to grasp. The same thing with the first, the hardest one for me with the first and third movement is because it's not really solid in how it's built. It's supposed to, and I get it, that's the point, is that it's kind of always wandering, it's always searching. But somehow, when I
give that effect,
right, give that effect without losing a sense of structure, it's a little bit difficult.
Yeah, it would imply, of course, that even in within something that, it's interesting, if you want to describe chaos in English, you would need an enormous vocabulary, right? You can just say it's nothing, it's catastrophic, it's not good enough. So even when something is not as balanced or as well placed as the march in the second movement, it still needs some variety in within. I'd love to start, why don't we do this? Why don't we start from the opening one more time? And I'd like to add, you see, I believe in, like you, I think it's very important to do it once, a rhythmical analysis, a psychological analysis, a Schenkerian analysis, a harmonic, you know, to pass as to a scan as many layers as you can, because then it's, if you will, one more level of awareness in within your playing. So I just want to mention something. When you did, do you have sensations like when, to me this is a left to right gesture, if you will. I don't feel it goes from, if I were a conductor,